Yeah, this is like totally grade six for me.
Yeah, grade six, grade
seven. Oh my gosh. On the Concordia boat in Sudbury. Am I saying that right? I'm not sure.
Good morning.
Rock here.
Nancy here.
It's the Cortina boat, I think.
Cortina? This thing, like, certain songs bring, like, memories. It's so much fun.
Of course.
That's why I often play, like, you know, 80s, 90s, 2000 music. It just brings me right back.
It's the best.
The simple times, right? Like, before all this technology, just, there's something to be said about just having to not be reached if you're going somewhere. Like, it's like, I don't know. There's just...
Yeah, 100%.
Nice. I love it. Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
Cheers to everybody.
Let me open this.
This is going to be a good one. Hurry up before I faint. This is my liquid breakfast. Oh, good morning, Jeanette. Good morning, Lise. Good morning, Lisa. Thank you so much for joining us today. Day three. Wow, day three of my juice cleanse.
We're all still alive.
I am really happy.
She hasn't killed anybody yet.
No, not yet. The day's early. It's day three. They say the third day is when you get hangry and tired. And I'm feeling a bit like weak and tired. I could sleep today. I could totally sleep today. And yesterday was, I was really... they were eating supper and we went like grocery shopping and I was smelling all these amazing foods and
I, licking the wrappers.
I was oh, I look glowier. Oh, okay. Well, there you go. Is that right? Yeah, okay. Yeah, I think it's I think I have to just foster the storm because I gotta say it's a little difficult, but I'm going to obviously I'm holding on to my strong why, which is to coach others how to do this, so I really want to go.
I'm going
to
be your first guinea pig
in
2 weeks.
Yeah, you are. And
like in a week and a half. So.
Yeah, and I'm gonna coach you.
You better bring the juice.
Hey. I'm fostering the storm. I'm going through the motions because I want to know how it feels when I'm coaching my clients. So to go through the motions and to go through the difficulties and to understand the difficulties, the hardship, the challenges.
Yeah.
But it's not bad. I mean, the third day, that's when they say it's the most difficult day because the body is running out of its reserves and it's looking for more toxins. I don't know.
No,
that's what James said this morning.
Yeah. Your body gets used to a certain type of lifestyle, and when you remove that, your body goes into withdrawal, whether you're eating good or not.
Yeah. Withdrawal.
Because just the fact of like
it.
you're used to eating and chewing, your body is like, hey, what's the matter with you there? Aren't you like... wanting to survive?
Yeah, it's like...
But you're getting all the nutrients and the vitamins and all that right into your... right away, straight pipe. So your body's adjusting to that.
It's adjusting, but it's also in shock, which is why it's important that you must rest during this cleanse. I'm doing this with a good friend of mine, and she is not resting so much. And I'm telling her, you gotta rest. And she's feeling a lot more symptoms of withdrawals because of it. So that's the thing. It's like if you feel like you're like a lot of people, it varies from person to person.
It's
but
a cleanse, right?
The withdrawals can be quite intense or it can be quite mild. But if you're not resting, you're going to go towards the more intense.
Yeah, I wouldn't suggest doing a cleanse the way you're doing it and still being full-blown active 100%. I would say dial it back.
Yeah, like even this morning I slept in till 6:45, which was great. And I'm just listening to my body. It's really important to listen to your body, but at the same time, your body might trick you because it wants to eat, but then you have to pay attention to what it wants to eat because it's probably craving the sugars and the chips and all those things, so it's important. So you gotta follow through. Little discipline goes a long way.
It's a week.
I know. This old saying about like discipline weighs ounces, regret weighs tons. I don't want to live in regret, especially when I want to serve people doing this afterwards. So it's good.
It's all good.
It's all good.
You'll benefit from that.
I know. You too. You. And like, you might start to question like, oh, is this safe? Because I'm starting to be like, oh, is this safe? Because if it wouldn't be for this program, which I really recommend if you're going to do a cleanse to follow, like a detailed program to really support you and guide you along the way. And I really trust this resource. So you have to trust the resource. You have to follow that program to the T. It really helps because it gives you the structure and the support And just the
guide. They've been doing it for years.
Guidance.
They got it tested.
Yeah. Like he does it three times a year. He interviews like a lot of people who do the same thing. Like one of them is actually like he went. One was suffering from cancer and went into remission doing this cleanse. He went a little longer, obviously, because he really wanted to clean out his diet, and his way of thinking was kind of toxic too.
Well, so. I think there's a good documentary, it's called Fat, Sick, and Nearly Dead.
Yeah.
It's all about juicing, and the guy juices for like 90 days.
Mm.
90 days, but he loses like 150 pounds.
Yeah.
So it's like incredible.
I know.
So, but the guys afterwards said that he doesn't do the juicing all year.
Oh, you can't. You can't do it for.
He just did it as a crash, like, because he was fat, sick, and nearly dead, basically.
Yeah, it's a good documentary, and it really helps to motivate you to keep going. That's the thing here. If you want to listen to things that will help you keep going. FMTV has great documentaries on that.
Yeah, it's good stuff. It's
Food Matters TV.
All sorts of stuff on there.
Transcendence 1 and 2, those are the documentaries that are really, really good. Hungry for Change is one of them too, that's really good too. So those are the things that you might want to listen to as you're doing a cleanse. And to work with somebody who's done it before. Follow a program. Yeah. I'm just saying, like, you can't just go doing this blindfolded. Like, it's like you gotta know what you're doing.
Yeah, because you're getting a lot less, but you want it to be higher end, mm-hmm. higher percentage. So you really want to make sure you're following a program that covers all sorts of vitamins and nutrients, so that you're not just doing carrot juice for a whole week.
Yeah, exactly. You know? And when you're doing a cleanse, super important to nourish yourself in other ways, because you know food is nourishment. I mean, even if it's something that's sweet and indulgence, that it's still nourishing you. It makes you feel good when you're eating those foods. So you got to find other things that's gonna make you feel good. So yesterday, I bought myself a candle. As lame as that sounds, I know it sounds really lame, but
she's like, "Can I get this?" I'm like, "Fill your boots."
To me, it brought me joy in that moment, and I can't wait to use it. Anyway, and Rock, the supportive husband that he is going to paint the bathroom today.
Yeah.
So when I come home from work, I'll have myself a nice bath with Epsom salt bath.
I got a bit of a problem with the contractor that came and did the job.
I know. Changed the flooring.
Half.
Half the flooring. Yeah, exactly.
And then it's like, I don't know. You know, the bottom line is, when you try to cut too many corners in life, you end up with shitty results. That's just the way it is.
That's a good metaphor for life, because he's like, yeah, I'm gonna... He took away like three quarters of the floor.
It's all rotten. I gotta change all this.
It was really rotten.
He just cuts 3/4 of the floor, brings it right back down to the original boards.
Mm-hmm.
This building is like 7 years old. 7D. And instead of taking the whole floor out and starting from scratch, he went halfway through. And then he rebuilt from there. And I'm thinking, you're never going to get that level. You're never going to get that to match perfectly. And sure shit, it got there. And it's like, yep. So instead of like taking the whole floor out and doing a good job, did half. And now he's got all these little pieces under to try and level it out. If you can feel it. I just, stuff like that. And then... It's all dirty in there. All dirty.
I know.
And he's like, is this good? Are you satisfied? And I'm thinking to myself, if this is where you're
call
at.
Call him back? Oh, I don't know.
No.
I don't know about
it's
that.
It's not my house. It's not my building. I'm not paying for it. I don't care. I'm going to do a good job myself.
Having said that, it is our space. And I need to feel good in my space.
That's why I'm painting the whole thing today.
That's why you're doing that today. And I'm really appreciative
it
for that. Oh, gosh. I can't wait to like
for free
have that done. We've been living this mess for a few weeks, and it's been a bit stressful. And me, I just the space needs to
very
really
stressful.
Feel
call him.
Well,
call him.
Yeah, because he wasn't showing up. And you know how some contractors are going to start a job and then they don't come for weeks. And like we were taking like showers and with sandals because you don't want to step on the floor, and it was all messy all over.
He was good in the sense that he cared about the mold. He cleaned all
and that's a worry.
He cleaned
itself,
all that,
which is why I'm doing a cleanse, by the way.
The floorboards were rotten anyways.
Yeah.
But and then he cuts corners, and then he kind of made a big old scratch in the wall, and he's like, oh, that wasn't there when I got it. No.
No. It wasn't there. Luckily, but you know what you're doing.
But I'll fix it. I'll fix it all, buddy. Don't worry.
Yeah,
Shane. Just get out of my house. So I can get to work.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Fixing your mistake.
So you're doing that today. And last night, I finished watching the season of This Is Us. Oh my gosh. Ah, this is a mind-blowing show. Seriously, girl.
Mind-blowing.
It is. It's like, what? You're leaving me in suspense till next year? Next season? Come on. I mean, if you guys are watching this, you gotta know that this is a good show. Feels good. Then I went to bed. So it was like, it was good. It was like the perfect recipe for yesterday's.
I watched a cartoon last night.
You watch a cartoon?
Yeah.
Okay.
Tales of Despero.
Is it good?
Yeah, it's a good story. Little mouse fighting rats.
Right.
It's whimsical.
Whimsical?
Yeah.
All right.
I love it.
So that's it for us today.
That's it for today. I mean, we're all alive. She hasn't killed anybody.
No, and my approach has changed with my massage therapy. The pressure is the same, but the pace is a little slower.
Wow. Yeah, because, you can't.
Because I'm like, am I like, you know, the protein deficiency? I'm like, ugh. But
you're fine.
I'm fine. I'm fine. I'm fine.
She's fine. I'm fine. Let's wrap it up.
All right.
As always,
we love you. We're thinking about you.
Cold showers.
Have yourself a fantastic day.
Cleanse your thoughts. Be a good person. Come on.